Coca-Cola All Outdoors. It's a Sunday morning. Well, not really morning. It's, let's see here, 11:12. I woke up late today. We were at Supercross last night. It was some good racing last night in Arlington, Texas at the AT&T Stadium. I can't even remember who won. Oh, Moosecan. His first win. Go, Moosecan. I'm so proud of him. He deserves that win. So my brother decided to go fishing this morning, and he called me around 8 o'clock. I was still asleep. He said, the bite is on, in a little tank or a little lake over here on the other side of town. It's a series of three different lakes in Hubbard, Texas. So we decided we're going to go over there, maybe get a little bit of footage. So he said he already caught 9 fish, and he caught about a 5-pounder. We don't have footage on any of that, but maybe we'll put a pic up here in a little bit. So we're going to go try to go over there. He says he's catching them on Cinco's and rattle traps. So I'm just going to take 2 poles, light line, do a Cinco setup on one, and we'll snuff it on the other. So I don't know. I'm going to go over there and try it out. It's pre-front conditions right now. Just now it's starting to get a little cool, I notice. I woke up this morning, it was muggy and hot. So, I mean, 75 degrees, but I think the temperature's starting to drop. So what probably happened is he got the bite on the pre-front condition. So I guess everything was right. Full moon last night, so I mean, maybe the bite was, you know, good early this morning. But we're gonna go out there and see if we can catch a few. So stay tuned. All right, so we made it to Hubbard, Texas. We're here at the Hubbard Lakes. As you can see, my brother's out there. I don't know if you can see him out there.
Just barely.
He said he caught some good ones this morning, so we're going to see. We're probably going to go out, throw a few. He said I just bought some light tackle, light line, spin cast rods. See if we can throw some weightless Cinco's out there and see what we can make happen. Coming over here picking this up shortly on the
jumbo. Got the drone. Gonna get some footage with that.
Heck yeah. Pretty day out here, man. Pretty front conditions. We're still, you know, the middle of February, so I'm thinking in the next 3 weeks the bite's gonna get better. We hope so. He had a good morning this morning, and you know, I'm itching to get something hooked. I don't have a bass hook for this year. So, yeah, let's see. Stay tuned. Hubbard, Texas lakes. Like again, it's a series of 3 lakes. We got one. I guess this is probably the second largest one. Right on the other side of the road, there's a small one, another small one, and then there's a one that's a little bit bigger than this. And then, oh, I got a bite. Yeah. And then at the very bottom, there's a small one that you have to crawl down like a little. Apparently that one's the most biggest fish, I'm thinking. Maybe less people fish it, it's harder to get to. I don't know, maybe it's good or something. he's been out here earlier this morning. He's caught 9 right here in this little area that we were at. And then caught like a 4 or 5 pounder. Yeah, we got video. He's got video. We got video to release. We'll show that later. Yeah, we're trying to see if we can get another bite right now. Throwing a swim bait, Cinco. I'm throwing a watermelon green, red flake Cinco. I'm gonna throw some of these Havoc swim baits. Skeet Reese design. Sick fish is what it's called. So, had a bite just a while ago over there, but let's see if we can get one on film here in a minute. Lubbock, Texas. Thank you for joining us today on Botello All Outdoors. Beautiful Sunday afternoon now. Lubbock, Texas. Trying to catch some fish, but
the bite just shut down. The
bite is shut down. Take a look right here. It's a pretty little lake, you know. Legend has it that this lake is haunted for some reason. And so they've seen a woman walk across from this side of the lake, there to your left, all the way to the right side. We can hear her screaming at night.
We get on her.
We get on her. So maybe it's true, maybe it's not.
Maybe we can do a night fish.
Maybe we need to come out here at night and see if we can get some ghost footage. I think people are just hearing pigs squealing.
But then again, it could be a haunted pig.
Yeah, you never know.
We have a haunted pig barn behind our house.
Yeah. I know. If you are into the haunted adventures, y'all need to come check out the Hubbard Lakes.
The Hubbard Lakes.
See if y'all can find the Yorona.
You abandoned explorers.
Yeah, I mean, all this side of Texas. I mean, what? You got Fort Parker not too far from here, you know?
Indian
burial grounds, maybe, you know. I've heard of Nacogdoches and places out that way is being haunted around Palestine, so it's possible. It's possible.
Whoa, did you see that?
I saw something right over there, man.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, man.
Dude, that was scary.
Get the boat going, dude. Get it to the other side.
We're losing power. We're losing power.
Man, y'all saw a hog or something.
I heard it too.
Yeah.
Some twigs breaking.
Let's get back to fishing. Good job, Chris.
Okay, he got one. He got one, guys. He got one.
Clear water. Clear on you, man. How stage this up back there? Look at that. Beautiful little. Yay. My first fish for 2017 on the Cinco.
Man, that's a fish tank fish.
Smell it, Chris. You gotta smell it.
Make out with it, why don't you?
Man, that's a monster Mondo right there. That's a Mondo.
Dude, that could go in our fish tank.
Put it up close to the camera and it'll look like
a
fish.
Oh my god.
Mondo!
Fish tank.
Now, do you feel better that you felt?
Hey, let me hold him. No, I'm just playing that one.
Okay. Let's release him. Let's get footage of the release.
Oh my gosh.
Hands like frozen. They're there. They're right there on that little beaver dam.
I wish I could have got the recording of this hook set. So dramatic.
Hey.
So dramatic.
Man, I almost got him all the way up into the boat. I almost hook set him in the boat.
And I almost flung him into the sky.
I wasn't even doing nothing. I was just letting it sit on the bottom and he had it the whole time.
Oh god.
Alright, so we're right here by the beaver dam.
Still.
I'm just running through a little bit of grass.
Competitor. Oh, he's got his. Oh, never mind. I thought that was a fish.
Man, dude, there could be a big one. Or you
your swim bangers.
I'm catching me another mondo out here. Let him fish the bumper out.
Why are you playing? I threw it out in the middle just for fun and I got a hit.
You did? Early.
Yeah. Oh, I only threw it two times, so I almost got a fish.
Just did set the hook. You a 2017 fish? That was my 2017 Hondo. That was my PB right
there. Dude, it was as big as this.
That was my PB. Leave me alone.
Okay, water on the tripod.
Oh, another hit, dude. He's...
Oh, no.
Got him. Good one.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, really?
You need a
licking
for you?
Oh, God. That's
what we're talking about.
God, Doug, he's getting me all wet.
Are you recording this?
Yes, I'm recording.
Oh, yes. Finally, dude. Yeah. Good job.
Dude.
That's about the size I just caught earlier today. That might be the same one. That ain't the same fish, dude. Man, no, this one's... Dude, this sucker got ticks all over it, man. What is that? Look at that. Get a video of that. Look, those are little... Those are mites. That's what those are called. They're mites. Man, that's a pretty fish, dude. Look at the fins on it. That's a female getting ready to spawn up. I said, those are beds right there.
Video does not do justice.
I called it. Good job.
That is way bigger.
Yeah, that's a good fish. That's a good fish, man. So, well, it's, why can't I remember what today's date is?
It's February
12th.
12th, okay, yeah. So middle of February, and we're in Central Texas, in the Hubbard Lakes, and water temperature, I'm still saying, is in the 50s.
58, probably.
Just now starting to warm up, and the forecast is showing, you know, we got a front coming in today, we're going to have rain for the next 2 days, and... It's supposed to cool down, but then it's going to warm up, and we're going to have 70-degree consecutive days, you know, of 70 degrees.
Hey, keep in.
And I'm thinking the fishing is going to get good in about 2 or 3 weeks.
Look at the base of that.
And what I want to say, too, about the Hubbard Lakes.
They're very good fish.
They're fighting fish because what I've heard about these lakes here in Hubbard, I mean, it's great for kayakers, of kayak fishermen out there. Come out and fish, but they say it's stocked with Florida strand bass, and I believe it. I mean, these bass look different than the bass we catch in lakes. They're chunky, and what I notice is right here, pointed out right there on that back fin, that looks like a Florida strand. It's got like fat right there on the back.
Tails are all fat in here too.
Yeah, so it's a different strand. So any YouTuber fishermen out there that like to try out new spots, I should come out to Hubbard, get a John boat, kayak, come out here and try y'all's luck, you know?
That was a big fish.
So, at least we got one good one, you know? And of course your release, which we weren't here this morning because I was still in bed.
Yeah.
After Supercross, some dedication.
Go Moosekin.
Some dedication.
Stay tuned, let's get another one. Get another one on the boat. All right, we got another one. Oh, he's another good one. Pull and drag. No, just calm down. Get him to the boat. Ain't got no net.
Oh, he's hitting good. He's hitting good. He ain't as big as you.
God, dog.
Hey, dude, that was a heck of a hook set. Dude. Put some grain.
Off the beds. We're still fishing off the beds.
I'll zoom in real quick.
All right, buddy. What do you think about these fish's eyes?
They're red. I've noticed something else, too. You notice a lot of the fish, you know, other bass and other lakes. Maybe it's the clear water. It shows more of their brown.
That fish wasn't going to come off.
I know what the intro is going to be.
So what are we using today? is, I don't even know what size that hook was. Show your setup, man. Small Texas rig. Senko style bait, small bullet head baits. I don't even know what ounce that is. It's finesse fishing at its finest. Cast over here. Apparently we're pulling them off these pads. I gotta get another Senko. Oh, hold on. I might have a little hit here, guys. Go, let's get out here. Get out here.
You see?
I think that's a watermelon red plate. Black one. Where it's at, somewhere in the boat. Throw a fresh one on too. Practice the check. Lose a fish due to frayed line. Smells good. I'm gonna put a fresh one on.
Still got your pant leg all wet.
My leg keeps on falling over here. You got another one. You got dude, we're getting our fish over there.
Hold up.
Hey. Hey, we're getting another.
Hey, where you go? There you are. Little chump.
We get salty.
Oh, that lady wanted was some recognition. Now she let us catch fish.
Paid our honors to
we're kidding, guys. This lake is not haunted. But we do have a haunted cemetery. Where we go and hunt?
We're going to do a night hunt one time. Going to the cemetery. I hope y'all enjoy our show. We're beginners at it. Just want to show people what we do. We love to hunt fish, ride their boats. Slow it up a little bit. I think they want it slow. Hey, that's two good fish we caught off this.
I'd like to get some more drone footage, but that man is on the lake, so I don't know.
Staged up right over here, or maybe the smaller ones right here. You know what I mean? That was fun.
So we got four fish here, and I caught nine.
Kayak, I bet doesn't scare the fish, huh?
I'm thinking too, you know, we spook them with this metal.
And we sit here for a minute.
Once we sit here for a minute, the bite picks up.
least two more.
Well, I think that, will we count that release as one?
We can. So we want to put like five on. Yeah. You know, good 20, 30 minute video with five. Another one. I got a jumper.
Got another one, guys.
Got the jumper. Oh, you got me down to the bottom, dude. Hold on. Right here. He's coming up.
Down. So why is he sideways?
I don't know. Get put the jumper down here.
I can't see, man. Just pull him up. Come on now.
Another red-eyed.
Stupid tripod.
Red-eyed monster. And we're over here just drifting and saying that there's not going to be, how are we going to catch him?
I just got to hit, dude. Go ahead.
Just keep on. There you go. Another decent.
Come on, bring him in front of the camera. I got decent, the tripod set up.
Decent little fish. I don't see no ticks on this one, but that other one had water mites on it. Smell the breath. They need to make a cologne called Bass Scent.
Get out.
Dude, I was just pulling it through the grass. Just pulling it through the grass, and he just swam and got it. I mean, it felt like a like a swim bait hit, you know? And we were drifting. There he is.
Another one?
I got another hit right off the bank over there. And I'm just reeling the swim, or the Senko. Just reeling it through real slow.
Dude, I think we come up on a pattern, dude. I don't feel a lot of grass right there.
No, I don't think there's as much grass up there, closer to the bank, because it looks darker. Well, that's where I caught him. I caught him way out there. And look, there's, you can see more of
that noise.
Oh no. It's that whistle.
Man, I'm scared, guys. I need to stop playing. That big buck come out next to us.
Haven't y'all heard?
Quit playing.
It would be freaky if our head blew
up. You know, something too, all the current is blowing into right here.
I'm gonna stop the recording. Someone gonna talk?
Alright, so we finally got one on camera. Trying to get situated here. We got this anchor and we were drifting. And we think we come across a pocket of beds. Some little
buff. Beaver dam right over here to the left.
So I'm a beaver dam. Beaver dam. And we think we come across some small beds, maybe some buck bass hanging up in there.
The bucklaws
are hanging up in here. And my leg fell asleep.
Pant leg is wet.
I don't care. Oh my god, it's really wet. Stage up right here for a second and see if we can hook up on a couple of them. As you saw, he just caught a little small one. What do you think? What are you thinking? What do you think about this whole situation?
I don't know.
Your bite was good this morning and now...
Just died off.
So...
I think it's going to be a lot of little ones in here.
Look at how clear the water is.
The water is crystal clear.
I think we drifted into the real shallow flat. I think we need to get back over there.
I do not like my biscuit. Well, I can't do everything at once. Pick up the talons. Just pick up the talons. Come on, man. talents. Pick up power pole.
Sorry.
Do it like professionals. Let's get back on these fish, man. Still, fishless 2017. How many have you caught?
About 10 today.
I can hook one here in a minute. Oh, looks like we got competition out on the lake. Let's zoom in on that.
Man, get over here. A lawn chair.
Right there. I wonder how far this point comes out. Stupid ass. For real.
No cussing on the YouTubes.
Chamanos. There it is.
Oh, it's a ladybug.
Chamanos.
Look. Ladybug. Bogus. Ladybug is dead. Okay, I just recorded this one. Edit. Edit.
Here we are again, closing out the day at Dairy Queen, Hubbard, Texas. Fine day of fishing today on the Dairy Queen Lake. Or the Dairy Queen Lake. The Hubbard Lake. We got some good footage of a couple of good ones that we caught. So, I'm glad y'all are watching our videos, so please subscribe, you know. Until next time.